Okay, I started recording. Now, till now, what we have done through this manual, manual means the training manual, we have covered up all other aspects like portable fire extinguishing equipment, fixed fire extinguishing equipment, and so on. Now, what is required from you, you should be able to draw a diagram and explain their working. That includes all the systems what we have seen. And I suggest you, even though I have not found it in your syllabus, but I suggest do dry powder one also, because after all, you all are smarter than other IMU institutes. So in interviews and all, if anybody asks questions, you will be much, much better off. So now we come to the next part. The next part, as we see here, see the section 5. Now here it is organization and techniques. What we are looking at is operational readiness, muster list. We all have done all of it. We are just retouching everything. Onboard training drills, fire control plans. Now fire control plan, later on I will put it on my Google Drive, which is the actual ship's plan. What I want you to do is just open it, have a look, and just be familiar with it so you know what is where. Contingency plans, how raising alarms, firefighting organization, ventilation, search problems, fire attack, compartment entry, how do you do it? And this is where we will go. By end of next week, we should be heading for finish. So one way or the other, we shall finish our course by 15th. I want you to take the tests which I have put on website. All these recordings are also, I have put on a YouTube channel of mine. So on YouTube, you put Captain Damle, you will get all the recorded lectures, whatever I could manage. So now we start. Operational readiness means what? Ship. At all times, ship has got fire protection system, firefighting system, fire appliances. They are there on board. But they must be maintained in a ready-to-use condition at all time. That is 24/7, things must be ready. You don't know when the fire will start. That is the reason. Everything must be ready. Protection system, firefighting system, fire appliances. Including people. Means you cannot be having a situation saying that, everybody is in emergency, we have got nobody. No, it will never happen. People will be ready. Okay. Now, structural fire protection is basically where the ship is constructed, class A bulkheads and also fire resisting divisions. Okay, same way the bulkheads. Detection alarm system, means of escape. Now, these are the standard things where we generally need good housekeeping standards and just seriousness that everything should be okay. Portable fire extinguishers, which are discharged, I have mentioned it n number of times that if you use it as per recommendation during fire drills, so people are more familiar, must be immediately recharged. Immediately. The job is not over till it is recharged. Now, if it cannot be recharged on ship, then take out the spare one and replace it. You cannot have a situation saying that, sorry, I don't have extinguisher because I used it up. I will be refilling it after a few days. No. Immediately. That means end of the fire drill for everybody. Others will say, okay, ho gaya. They generally have a meeting and all to analyze it. But generally, third mate and cadet will start refilling it immediately, and within next 1 hour's time, everything will be back to normal as if nothing has happened. Now, every part of LS&FFA is covered under maintenance plan. And today they are all computerized maintenance plan. So there are reminders, they tell you this week, this is what you have to do, and so on. The plan maintenance systems are in existence, let's say around 25 years. because 25 years ago I worked on them to place it on ship. So it is over 25 years. So you have got everything computerized. There are job orders, work orders, etc., etc. Now the maintenance plan, what all it needs? Firemen, pumps, hydrant, hoses, nozzles, international shore connect. See, these are the items which are covered. Fixed fire detection, fire alarm system, fixed fire extinguishing systems and other fire extinguishing appliances, automatic sprinkler if they are fitted on ship, fire detection alarm system, ventilation system, emergency fuel shutdown. Those are those valves I had told you, quick closing valves. Fire doors and their controls. Now, fire doors also have a remote control because they are left open. When they are left open, they are sort of, with a magnetic thing door holder. And then there is a system in case of fire alarm, it will just release it and close it automatically. Then, general alarm, emergency escape, breathing devices, portable fire extinguisher, and their spare charges. Okay. It is not only extinguishers. We are also looking at spare charges. Now, these spare charges are here, but believe me, all of them have got some spare parts. Wherever there are spare parts, they are also covered under your plan maintenance system and inventory systems. Now, what happens is this is coming little separately because there is a requirement, the minimum requirement defined by SOLAS, whereas the spares here, spares which are required for all of them are recommended by manufacturers and accordingly they are kept. So here it will change, but here it is more specific. Now, on passenger ships, this is added up low location lighting and public address systems. Now, on ships, you have got public address system, you can also add up on your ship. Anything more than this is okay. You cannot reduce something. You can add something more because your ship has got advantage of certain newer systems or because of ship was registered in a specific country which demands higher standards. Possible. Now, for tankers, you have got add-on like inert gas system, deck foam systems, cargo pump room safety arrangements, flammable gas detectors. Now, flammable gas detectors are fixed as well as portable. So, portable ones are also covered under your plan maintenance system, including calibration and the spare parts required for that. Then we come to muster list, which we have done earlier. Muster list has got like as a big poster. And this must be ready before ship is put to sea. That means before ship sails out of port. Because in port, you may have crew changes. So all must be updated before you sail out. Sometimes we also do a drill in the port before sailing. That is because you have got more than 25% people have changed, so you want to do the drill. It's nothing abnormal. Then, what is the muster list? Gives clear instructions in case of emergency, what do you do, where you gather, and what are your duties, etc., etc. It is displayed all over. Every deck will have it, plus additional navigation bridge, engine control room, crew accommodation, mess rooms, etc., etc. What all is there, the alarm signals and action taken, how order to abandon ship will be given, very specific. Now I have explained you in a classroom, abandon ship is on cargo ship, it is by captain's direct order, that is he tells you vocally, abandon ship, or captain or person in charge. Now what happens on cargo ship, you know people. You know who is captain. What happens on passenger ship? if you are paying very high type of money and you are a privileged one, obviously you have met captain. But everybody hasn't met captain. That is the reason it is given that how the order will be given is mentioned there. So that you have got clarity about it. Yes, now is the right order. There is no fake news. Then location of assembly station, procedures of rescuing passengers trapped in cabin. These are the things which are on passenger ships. But to join passenger ship, you will be doing extra course, crew, crowd management and all. So that is where it will be covered. Then duties assigned to various members of the crew. That is, see, you are a group of about maybe 20, 24 persons. Those 24 persons have got their specific duties. Somebody is given closing of watertight doors, fire doors, etc. Whatever is the thing. Now, if somebody is given, okay, your job is life raft, to ensure the life rafts are launched. Somebody is member of the boat, you know, lifeboat. There is a team of five persons who are going to launch the lifeboat, bring it to embarkation deck, etc. Then mustering of passengers, that is on passenger ships, you may have, and it's possible, you may have less than 12 passengers, 12 passengers. So it's not a passenger ship, but you have passengers. You have ships like that who carry passengers. So in that case, it's a specific instruction. Communication equipment. Normally these days it will be walkie-talkie, public address system and all. Firefighting parties, who all are there and so on. So all the duties are explained. Now this part is dealing with passenger ships basically, but in case you have got passengers, this extra supplies, etc., it's going to come in. This keeping order, this is why you do that crowd management course. Now the important one, these are the duties, etc., we see, but you also have something here, are maintained in condition. So person who is in charge of maintaining LSA and FFA, their names are also on muster list, giving, saying that these people maintain everything, so that you know in case you have got any doubts, anything, whom to look up. And the substitution for key personnel, that is one more point which you cannot miss if you are talking about muster list. Substitutes for key person. Now these are the important points. The rest of them everybody can write. This who is responsible for maintenance, key substitutes, and another one which we covered here. How order to for abandoned ship will be given. These three must not be missing from your answer anytime. Because this is what differentiates between the full 5 marks and getting 4 marks and 5 marks. Emergency instructions are given. Now, what happens is all the ships have got this muster list and also they have got cards. The cards are generally on your door inside, which tells you this is your job in case of emergency and these are the emergency instructions. Every cabin will have this card. Some of them got even smaller ones which you can put it around you, no problem. Again, all the things are usual, signals are, because we don't really believe that people will react correctly. So we ensure that you don't have to recollect out of memory, because memory may not work when there is emergency alarm. Happens to people, few are like born leaders, cool guys, but many can panic. So it's nothing abnormal. So we give them everything, okay, now reset again and restart reading. You are okay. Like this card here, emergency procedure. See, for person, emergency signal is this, 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 both muster is this, your station is here, where you are supposed to be, and so on. So this is the card which you will find at the inside the door. Now normally what happens, general alarm is 7 more short blast followed by 1 blast on ship's whistle. Now ship's whistle is quite loud. If you are using the one on top of bridge, you will hear it inside the accommodation very well. Plus, we also have it connected with the internal alarm system so that even the bells and all, everything will ring accordingly. And moment you get it, you don't think about anything, drop everything and go for your emergency station. Now this is what we have already covered, that emergency, abandoned ship will be covered accordingly. Okay. Now you have done training. You have trained people because you did our standard course, correct? Now STCW course is training ashore before you join the ship, but that is general training. So on ships, it is compulsory to have onboard training. Now, okay, like you join first ship, you will be excited, second ship, onboard training, and after 2-3 ships, you will find everything becomes very natural for you. So they must get instructions in fire safety on board, everything, whatever we are talking about, they have to get. And somebody is going to, first day is familiarization. First, when you join the ship, about 2 hours will go in just knowing the ship and where are the safety equipments and what is the standard thing and what are your duties. Everything is explained first. This is the first instruction you get on ship. Later on, the more specific things will come. Like suppose your duty is going to be wearing breathing apparatus. So you will be made familiar with the breathing apparatus. You will be given practice to use it, how to wear it, making sure that there are no gaps in knowledge. There is no confusion anywhere. Then emergency escape breathing device, how to use it. That is actually very easy, but you should be better than anybody else. And so on. Now, what happens is most of the things are common. So you don't need very specific things before sailing, but before you get out of the port, after joining the ship, you finish this familiarization first. Then only it is safe to take you to sea. Now what happens is fire training manual is provided in crew mess room, recreation room, or in every cabin, depending on what ship is doing. Some ships may have in every cabin, some ships may have limited copies, but it will be there. It's always accessible to everybody. It is in working language of the ship. It is not a typical legal document. It is easily understood and illustrated wherever possible. Why? Because the pictures speak a lot. Most of the safety material is illustrated, most of it. Very little you need to understand because, you know, our languages are different. Cruise language may be Tagalog, Filipino crew. Some may be Indonesian, some. So there can be. So illustrated means everybody gets the picture clearly. Yeah, this is what I'm supposed to do. Then you also have audio visual forms. Like, you know, that is, you have got the set of training videos on board. So that is audio visual form. You may have, like, you know, like when you fly, you have got two things. One is like the air hostesses and our staff, stewards and all, they give you this thing about emergency. Other one is some of them just show you a video. Both are same. Now, what fire training manual? Okay, now remember one thing, the many types of training manuals. So fire training manual is different than safety manual and so on. So fire training manual is what it must give. This is a nice one for 5 marks. General fire safety practices, precautions to the dangers of smoking, electrical hazards, etc. General instructions on firefighting activities, procedures, how to notify a fire, and use of manually operated call points. Manually operated call points, I repeat, are small press switches. Meanings of ship's alarm, operation and use of firefighting system and appliances, use of fire doors, smoke dampers, emergency escape systems and appliances. Appliance only one come, that is EVD. Now, see, this is the training manual and fire safety operational booklet. Another one. It has to be in working language of the crew in each crew mess room, etc., etc. Must be crew's responsibility in for the general fire safety while working cargo and underway and so on. Now, when you're carrying hazardous cargoes, okay, here, then booklet will provide reference to relevant firefighting. So code of safe or solid bulk cargoes or with different codes, you know, there are many codes. So the specialized publication. So it will give you a reference to it, and it gives you all the instructions. Like additionally, like tankers will have the how to preventing fire spread to cargo area, vapors. That means, you know, gas purging and all, gas freeing, all the instructions and procedures are there. So it is a fatter one. See the difference between the two. So when you prepare yourself, this is a separate one, and prepare probably where these are typical 5 marks. Now, this is where the interesting part comes, because on many ships, many companies, they put both together. The equivalents are both together. So it is possible that they are together, but you know there may be two or one, but both are separate things. Even though the materials might be crisscrossing each other, it's okay. Now, when we talk about fire drills normally in good company are weekly. Requirement legally maybe one drill every month, but most of the ships it is weekly. Then if more than 25% people change, you must do it before you leave the port within 24 hours. That is if you are sailed out. As far as I go, you should prefer to do it in the port, because moment you sail out, you may get emergency, even though law permits you that you must do within 24 hours after leaving the port. Okay, once in a while it may happen that you just didn't get chance to do it in the port, but by and large most of the ships will prefer to do it before sailing out of the port. Now, for ships entering service for the first time, that is you have got a 100% new crew, there definitely before sailing. Because when we say 25% changing, you have got 24 hours to do it after sailing, but preferably in the port. But when you have got a new takeover, a brand new ship or the sail ship, means, you know, your owner bought the ship and you joined the ship, everybody is new, then must be done before sailing. passenger ships, you have a lot more drills, huh? Because of variety of reasons. Because sometimes what happens is you are touching 2-3 ports. So every port you will have passenger ship, and then you sail out for deeper voyage, then once a week. But they are different altogether. Now, on RoRo passenger ships on short voyages, you remember the definition from SOLAS, short international voyage, because this short one can be just few hours. In Europe, in Japan, and this Korea and all, a lot of them use a lot of these RoRo passenger ships so that you don't have to travel so much on the road. You get your car in, you go from one port to other, get off there, and you continue. Europe, you travel like that. Now what happens is, we are talking now about the fire drills. Now, how do you plan? There is something called a planner. There is a planner available. It is just nothing but a tabulated information, and you work out. So what happens is, you work out the different drills. You list them. Then you work out frequency based on weightage you are giving it. And then you plan it in such a way that everything, like if I say I want it once a month, that means every month that drill must be there. So it is just filling up a sort of a timetable. That is a planner. Now, what is the fire drill? When we talk about fire drill, first thing is reporting at the right location, prepared for assigned duties, fine. Then we must start ship's fire pump and make sure that water is going wherever you want. That means two hoses must reach one spot. Then you check fireman's outfits, then other personal rescue equipment, check relevant communication. Do you hear me right now? Anybody on chatting? Do you hear me? Okay, fine, because I am getting some signal now. Maybe battery is going down. You all must be happy, no? Okay, it goes through this point, checking the communication equipment, checking the operation of various watertight doors, etc. Arrangement. Means we check everything in this, in fire drill, whatever equipment, anything, what we use. And when we use it during equipment, during the drill, immediately after the drill, you make sure it is back to normal, as if it was never used. Why do we need it? You know, the drills are drills, like net practice. Drills are nothing but net practice. So that is how we look at it. Net practice. Okay. One thing is, just go through this and you will find that these are the things, like practice is why you should know where is the equipment, what is the organization, who is going to be in charge of what, familiarity with people, equipment, others. Then you develop appropriate responses. Once you start practicing, you do more things. No? Response time will definitely come down if you practice it. Reputation and all. Then the team leaders. We'll have to manage the whole situation. So that is also analyzed and seen. What all limitations are there? How do we overcome these limitations? And some people like to avoid, but that is generally on cargo ship, it is not. Passenger ships, some passengers may not, but cargo ships, you are not going to get away. It is compulsory for everybody, mandatory. Okay, we are coming to fire control plan. So, okay, I am also running out of battery now. So, anyway, we have done a fair amount. So, this one, I am going to put one. You do some reading on this, what all is supposed to show. And I will put one, hopefully by Monday, because I have to search where it is. And I think it is already in your notes. There are two fire plans, which have been the actual real fire plan scan. So it's a high resolution image. And that you should be able to, just for a practice, just look at it. That's it. Just to get familiar, yeah, this is how it looks. It should not look some strange thing to you suddenly. That's all. Because later on, you will learn to read the plans. Sate sir used to do that. He used to open the plan and make people go through it. So fire plan we will do next time. And you have a look, because I will put it up hopefully today only on Google Drive and send you the link. Okay. So now let's see, we are 62 and chat me anything is going on. Nothing. Because I am getting TTT, like it is telling me I am dying. Okay, any doubts, put it on chat so that I know if there are doubts. I am unmuting all. Whatever we have done, any doubts are there? Huh? Are you understanding what we are doing?
Sir. Sir.
Yes. Bolo. You are understanding what we are talking?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts are there? See, if you have got doubts, you can also put it on. I don't know, WhatsApp, I don't care. I'm getting fed up the way WhatsApp goes on. It's too many of them, which I never had in my lifetime. But anyway, you put it on email out so that I can cover it up. Huh? That's good enough. So right now, I assume temporarily no doubts. Later on, doubts may arise.
Yes.
So the fire resolution that is once in every 2 weeks, no?
Every once. Week, all the ships do it, but once a month is compulsory.
Once a month is compulsory, or once in every 15 days?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Now there are, but all the companies definitely do it every week. So that way they take care, because the flag state requirement can change. 15 days every 2 weeks. Okay?
Yes, sir.
And that is, some states will say. Some states will say every week. Some states will say up to 1 month. But you can say that weekly. It's good enough. And if it is a really solas related one, then you go for 2 weeks.
And so solas basically says once in every 2 weeks.
Yeah, I think so. But I will also need to check it again. But you better check it.
Yes, sir.
So now I will